Students, today in our 12th standard physics class from the lesson Magnetism and Magnetic Effects of Electric Current, this is the session number 12, and today we are going to learn about the magnetic field produced along the axis of the current carrying circular coil and the force on moving charge in a magnetic field. Students, today using this term magnetic field produced along the axis of the current carrying circular coil, we are going to obtain a relation for this. Right? See, this is a circular coil which carries a current I. Okay, so we are going to find the point P here, which you learn in the first lesson from the axial line question. This question is related to the axial line question which you learned in the lesson 1. Let's move to the lesson. Let us consider a current carrying circular coil or a loop. Okay. And it has a radius R. This is the radius R. Both sides, the radius is R. Students, let's take I as the current flowing through the wire in the direction which I show in the figure, which is flowing through this direction, right? And R be the vector joining the current's elements IDL and C and at the point P. R be the vector joining the current elements IDL. We take here the current element IDL and the point C and the point P. Okay. The magnetic field at a point P on the axis of the circular coil, which is at a distance from Z to the center of the coil O, is computed by taking two diametrically opposite line elements. This is two diametrically opposite line elements, a DL and a DL, which is from C and D, which is from the DL. We take this DL from C and D. Remember, R be the vector joining the current line elements. I already explained you. IDL at C at the point P. Now, according to the Biot-Savart law, which we learned in the earlier classes, dB vector is equal to mu naught by 4 pi IDL divided by R square into R cap. The magnitude of dB, right, the magnitude of this dB vector is mu naught, dB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi IDL sin theta divided by R square. We know the value of sin theta is equal to 90 degree, right, the value of sin theta is equal to 90 degree, so sin 90 degree is equal to 1. And we put it as mu naught by 4 pi IDL divided by R square, because sin theta or sin 90 degree here is 1. That's what I explained you. Theta is the angle between IDL and R, and the theta is equal to 90 degree. So we take the sine value out. It is represented by the value 1. Now the direction of DB is perpendicular to the current element IDL and CP. See, the direction of the DB is perpendicular. It is perpendicular to the current element IDL and CP. This is CP, which you can see here. So it is therefore along the PR, which is perpendicular to CP. Okay, therefore the PR, right, the PR, which is perpendicular to the current element IDL and the CP. The magnitude of magnetic field P, the magnitude of the magnetic field P, which is due to the current element as at D, this is due to the current element at D, is same as that for the current element at C. Both have the same distance. You can see the point from C to P and the length from D to P is same. Because of equal distances from the coil, but the direction is along the PS. The direction is along the PS, which you can see here. PS. Okay. The magnetic field DB is resolved into two components. The magnetic field DB is resolved into two components here. You can resolve it into two components, and the components are DB cos pi along y direction. DB cos pi along y direction, this direction, and DB sin pi along the z direction, this direction, along the z direction. Okay, one is cos value and another one is opposite side is sin value. Substituting all this, we get B vector is equal to integral of DB vector. While integrating this, we get DB vector sin pi into k cap, because we represent the value from z, we put k, and already we know the value of DB vector, is it? That is from the Bayes-Savart law. While substituting this, let's take the I mu naught by 4 pi out of the integral, and therefore we get dl by r square into sin pi into k vector. I already told you this Bayes-Savart law is very important while applying for all this magnetic and current carrying coils from the triangle OCP. OC and P. Triangle OC and P. Sin pi is equal to, we are taking again the adjacent side by hypotenuse rule. Sin pi is equal to R, okay, R divided by R square plus Z square. R divided by R square plus Z square. The whole bracket 1 by 2, which is from this R square is equal to R square plus R plus R square is equal to R square plus Z square. While taking this square, we put a root here. Instead of root, we put 1 by 2 here. And substituting these values in the above equation, we get B vector is equal to I mu naught divided by 4 pi, which we have as a constant value, and integrating this dl by r square into the value r by r square plus z square, the whole bracket 1 by 2, which we get from the last equation. Now substituting this, already we know this small r square is equal to r square plus z square the whole square, is it? R square is equal to r is equal to r square plus z square, and substituting this we get b vector is equal to mu naught by 4 pi integral dl divided by r square plus z square the whole square. Instead of this small r, we substitute r square plus z square into this value r divided by r square plus z square the whole bracket 1 by 2. Instead of putting a root, we put 1 by 2. Students, as you know, if you multiply this r square plus z square the whole square into r square plus z square the 1 by 2, you get the value r square plus z square the whole bracket 3 by 2. That means you add this power and this power 1. So 1 plus 2 is equal to 3 divided by 2. We don't multiply the powers, we add the powers in the mathematical substitutions. I think you know all these things from your mathematical classes. Therefore, b vector is equal to I mu naught by 4 pi is equal to r square divided by r square plus z square the whole bracket 3 by 2 into k cap into integral dl. We have to still we left this dl to be integrated. And if we integrate the line element from 0 to 2 pi r, do you know why we have to integrate this from 0 to 2 pi r? Because this is the circumference, right? So we have to integrate this from 0 to 2 pi r. Okay, this is the circumference. So we integrate from 0 to 2 pi r. While integrating this from 0 to 2 pi r, we get b vector is equal to I mu naught by 4 pi r square divided by r square plus z square the whole bracket 3 by 2 k cap into l. That means we integrate the dl, and while integrating dl we get l from 0 to 2 pi r, from 0 to 2 pi r. And substituting the value of 0 to 2 pi r, we get b vector is equal to I mu naught by 4 pi, we put the 2 pi r square divided by r square plus z square the whole bracket 3 by 2. Now students, you can cancel this 2 and this 4. If you cancel this 2 and 4, you get the value as b vector is equal to I mu naught divided by 2 into r square divided by r square plus z square the whole bracket 3 by 2. I substitute n here because n number of the turns is n number, so we put n here, and the magnetic field at the center of the coil is b vector is equal to n mu naught divided by 2. We already cancelled this 4 by 2 and this pi and this pi. So we have only 2. N I mu naught by 2 into k. Because z is equal to 0. The distance which it travels in the right hand side is 0. While putting z equal to 0, r square plus z square, that means z is equal to 0, the whole term become 0. So we have only n I mu naught divided by 2 into k cap. Dear students, next, let's see the force on a moving charge in a magnetic field. When an electric charge Q is moving with velocity V in the magnetic field B, it experiences a force Fm and it is called magnetic force, which we learned in the Lorentz force. After careful experiments, Lorentz deduced the force experienced by a moving charge in the magnetic field as Fm is equal to Q V vector into B vector. Fm is equal to vector is equal to Q V vector into B vector. So this Fm is termed as the magnetic force. And in magnitude, Fm is equal to QVB sin theta. Using this equations 1 and 2, it implied that this Fm is directly proportional to the magnetic field B. Right? This Fm, that means this magnetic force is directly proportional to the magnetic field B. And this Fm is directly proportional to the velocity V of the moving charge. This Fm is directly proportional to the velocity V of the moving charge V. And this Fm is directly proportional to the sine of the angle between the magnetic field and the velocity, right? It is the sine of the angle theta between the velocity and the magnetic field. Again, using all this, we receive the four important, that is, Fm is directly proportional to the magnitude of the charge Q. Fm is directly proportional to the magnitude of the charge Q. The direction of Fm is always perpendicular to V, that means velocity and B, as Fm is the cross product of V and B. The magnetic force is always perpendicular to V and B because it is a cross product of V and B. The direction of Fm on negative charge is opposite. You can see here the direction of Fm on negative charge is opposite to the direction of Fm on the positive charge, provided other factors which are identical as shown here. Okay, in the last picture we saw the Fm in the vertical direction y-axis, now it is in the minus x-axis. The velocity V of the charge Q is along the magnetic field B vector, then the Fm, that means the magnetic force, is zero here. Finally, let's move to the definition of Tesla. You may come across the value T. Let's define the value of Tesla. The strength of the magnetic field is 1 Tesla if one unit charge moving in it with unit velocity, if it experiences a unit force, which is equal to 1 Tesla is equal to 1 Newton second divided by Coulomb per meter, or 1 N is equal to AM, which is equal to 1 N A minus 1 into M minus 1. So 1 Tesla is equal to 1 N A minus 1 M minus 1. Thank you, students.